Next topic, that is shear stress. This is shear stress, or it is called shearing stress. So we have discussed the effect of bending stress. Ignoring the shearing stress or ignoring the effect of shearing forces, now we will consider the shear stress and will neglect the effect of bending moment. So at each point of a given beam, the shearing stress result due to shear force, and this shear stress act between successive longitudinal layer of the beam and tending to resist sliding between these two layer. These longitudinal shearing stress will balance the variation of bending stress along the beam. So this result due to shear force, it acts between successive longitudinal layer of the beam . Suppose in a given beam, this is a given beam, neutral axis is there, this is subject to some bending moment, there are some unbalanced shear forces, so there will be shear stress between the longitudinal layer. So this shear stress can be calculated as follows. We will go directly to the formula without having any derivation. So shearing stress, this will be S A Y bar divided by I into B. So S is the shearing force. This result due to variable bending moment. So dm by dx, Y bar, we will consider A into Y bar, not Y bar. So A Y bar is the moment of sectional area above the point about neutral axis, I is the moment of inertia, B is the width of beam. To understand this, we will take a rectangular section or rectangular beam. Let us assume this is the section, this is the neutral axis, this is the width of the beam, width of the cross section, or width, this is depth of beam. So let us assume the shear stress is sigma, shear stress is tau at a distance y from the neutral axis. So let this is our rectangular section. Let B and D be the width and depth of cross section. Let tau be the shear stress at a distance y from neutral axis. So in this case we will consider area above that part, because we have written moment of sectional area above the point about neutral axis. So this is the point about which we have to find out shear stress. So we will consider area above that. So our area will be, area of this cross section will be B D by 2 minus Y. Our Y bar will be, this is the midpoint, so this will be Y. This will be Y bar. So Y bar will be D by 2 plus Y by 2. Then our moment of inertia I will be BD cube by 12. Therefore AY bar will B by 2 D by 2 minus Y D by 2 plus Y. So this will be B by 2 D square by 4 minus Y square. So therefore we can write shearing stress tau as S A Y bar divided by I into B. So shear stress area is B by 2 D square by 4 minus Y square divided by I, in place of I will write BD cube by 12 into B. So this tau will be 12 SD divided by B into BD cube into 2 D square by 4 minus Y square. So the maximum value of shear stress is at the neutral axis when Y is at 0. So tau is, so tau is maximum when Y equal to 0. And this tau maximum can be given as 12 S by BD cube into D square by 8. This will be 3 by 2 S by BD. So this S by BD is the mean shear stress. So this will be 3 by 2 tau mean. So this is called mean shear stress. Therefore we can write tau max equal to 3 by 2 tau mean. So the variation we can write as follows. For this, at this point the tau will max, at this point when Y equal to D by 2 this will be 0. So this will be 0, so this will be symmetrical. So this will be tau max. So this is variation of shear stress. Similarly we can draw the variation of shear stress for other cross section. For example, let us consider a I beam. So this is a I beam. So for this the variation will be as follows. First it will follow parabolic path up to some distance. Then since the area is decreasing at this point, therefore the shear stress will increase and it will be maximum at the neutral axis. So this will suddenly increase at like this way. This will increase suddenly like this way, first linearly, because at this point area is decreasing. So first it will increase on both sides, and then from this point as the distance decreases the shear stress will increase, but it will not so sharp, so it will slightly, so like this. And since it is symmetrical, so like this way. So this will be the variation of shear stress. Similarly, if our cross section is hollow, for example this is our hollow cross section, this is our neutral axis, this is the cross section. So for this, first our shear stress will increase, and then since area is nowhere, so it will increase fastly, so like this way. So this will be the variation of shear stress. Similarly, if we have T-shaped cross section, this is our T-shaped cross section, so this will first it will increase, then it will remain constant, then it will have like this way. So this will give the variation of shear stress. If we have star type beam like this, so for such type of beam, this is the neutral axis, so this will increase up to this. Since area is decreasing, since area is increasing not decreasing, so it will decrease, it will be symmetrical about this point, so this will be the variation of shear stress. So in this way we can approximately draw the shear stress. Similarly, if we have a composite beam, it will be same as I section. Now let us take few problem, then we can appreciate the given system. Let us note down the problem. A timber beam 150 mm by 250 mm in cross section is simply supported at its ends and has a span of 3.5 meter. The maximum safe allowable stress in bending is 7500 kilonewton per meter square. So find the maximum safe UDL, that is uniformly distributed load, which the beam can carry. What is the maximum shear stress in the beam? For the UDL calculated, so let us solve the given problem. So since the beam has been simply supported at its end, so let us find out the maximum bending moment. So the maximum bending moment at the center of beam having span L is M equal to W L square by 8. So where W is the loading, UDL or uniformly distributed loading. So this can be calculated. W we have to calculate, L is 3.5 square by 8, so this is 1.53 W. We will assume W in kilonewton per meter, so W in kilo Newton per meter. So this will give the moment of the bending moment, this will come in kilo Newton meter. The cross section of the beam is as follows. This is the cross section of beam. This is the neutral axis. The width of the beam is 150 mm and the depth is 250 mm. So the moment of inertia will be this I will be 0.15 into 0.25 cube by 12. So it will be 1.953 into 10 to power minus 4 meter power 4. Now the distance of topmost fiber from the neutral axis, this. So distance of, because that will give the shear stress. So distance of topmost fiber from neutral axis, this y equal to 0.25 by 2, so this is 0.125. so let us use the relation m by I equal to sigma by y. So this will give m equal to sigma I by y. Therefore we can use bending stress is given 7500 kilo Newton into moment of inertia 1.953 into 10 to the power minus 4. Value of I is 0.125. So this will come 11.718 kilo Newton into meter. Now we can equate both bending moment. So 1.53, because both will same, equal to 11.718. So this will give W equal to 7.66 kilo Newton per meter. So this will be our loading. Now with this we can calculate maximum shear stress. So due to this UDL, the maximum shear force S max will be WL by 2. So this can be calculated. W is 7.66 into L is 3.5 meter divided by 2. So this will give 13.4 kilo Newton. Now maximum shear stress will be, so maximum shear stress will be, tau max will be S A Y bar by I into B. So this will be 13.4 into area is 0.15 into 0.25, sorry 0.125, because we are calculating only above the neutral axis. So this is 0.125 into 0.0625 divided by the moment of inertia is 1.953 into 10 to the power minus 4 into 0.15. So this will give 536 kilo Newton per meter square. So this will give maximum shear stress.